Social progress and social justice. It's not a linear story. It's not a story of victory followed by victory. It's a tale of bitter setbacks and defeats, of terrible sacrifice, of horrendous cost, but all followed by eventual triumph. The early trade unionists, they were persecuted, like the Tolpuddle martyrs who were deported to Australia for organising a trade union. But workers did win rights in this country. Women and men, when they marched to St. Peter's Square in Manchester in 1819 to demand the right of the people to determine the future of their own country, they were charged at by cavalry and maimed and killed. And the Chartists, the world's first great working class political movement, as they fought for all men, regardless of class, to have a vote, they faced the full force of the state. But did democracy not prevail in time? The suffragettes, demonised in their time as anarchists and terrorists, locked up in prisons and force-fed, but did women not warrant the right to vote in this country? And those who fought for a welfare state, who were belittled and ridiculed and dismissed, but was the welfare state not built? And those who fought racism and sexism and homophobia, who were battened by police officers, who were spat at in the streets, but did discrimination and prejudice not face hammer blows? So much bitter defeat, so much sacrifice. But in the end, we saw these great triumphant victories because people stood up and they fought for justice. Now friends, at times of victory, we learn from those ancestors not to be triumphalist and complacent, and at times of defeat, not to be despondent and despairing. But the one thing we always learn is this: everything we have, all our rights and all our freedoms, they were not given to us by the goodwill and generosity of the powerful. They were fought for from below by people with huge sacrifice and huge cost. Your mothers, your fathers, your grandmothers, your grandfathers, your ancestors before them. Friends, we stand on the shoulders of giants, and we must show the same determination and conviction and hope that they showed. Because if we do, if we show that determination, if we show that hope and conviction and foresight that these people showed against far more insurmountable odds than ourselves, then we will build a new society. Not a society run as a racket for those at the top, but a society run in the interests of the real wealth creators, working people. Let's stand together, let's fight together, and friends, let's win these battles together. Thank you.